So here I'm going to go over collecting footwear evidence. Well, maybe a little bit obvious in the example and that I've shown here in sand and snow, it is possible to collect footwear in less ideal conditions if you follow proper procedures. So first off, when we're looking at footwear evidence, it's always left no matter if it can be found or not. So it's important to keep that in mind and something to always be on the lookout for, because it's physical contact between the footwear and the visible surface. And it leaves, it transfers class and also potentially individual characteristics, and both can be used for identification of possible suspects. Now this footwear is class evidence. Keep in mind, class characteristics can be used to eliminate suspect shoe or suggest a shoe could have made the impression. Compare the sizes and patterns of the prints from the suspect to the shoe that is recovered. So again, just the basic size can help classify or potentially eliminate if you have a list of suspects that could have been present at the crime scene. Now, we talked about individual characteristics. So when we're talking about shoes, those are generally class characteristics. But now when we're looking at these individual characteristics, these are used to identify the exact shoe. However, keep in mind that these can change over time. So if you're able to capture the shoe very closely to when the crime may have occurred, that's going to give you the strongest matching possibility for these individual characteristics, which can include small cracks or small tears or small imperfections found in the tread. Now, information application. We're linking the suspect or victim to the scenes, or it could link to crime scenes. Location of the prints can lead to more evidence to be found or investigated, can refute alibis or a defense by an accused person proposing to show that he or she could not have committed the crime in question, could help strengthen the fact that they could be there. And we see here a couple kind of comparisons of impressions found at the crime scene, test footwear impressions, photo of the outsoles, and photo of the suspect's footwear to see how these may or may not match up. Now, the suspect's person's footwear, all footwear a suspect owns should be seized for comparison. Shoes are needed to make test impressions. This can be very important for trying to identify those individual characteristics, because you want to capture them as soon or as quick as you can between when the crime was committed and when you can get your hand on those pieces of evidence. When you're looking at footwear, as I said, it'll be found everywhere, but just because you find a footwear impression doesn't mean that it is automatically from the suspect. You want to eliminate those that are innocent that were also present at the crime scene. So it includes footwear worn by police officers, medical personnel should be accounted for and considered for impressions left at the crime scene, because these are going to be footprints you're going to want to eliminate from the investigation process. Looking at those known footwear impressions, an examiner will make impressions of known footwear and compare them to the suspect's footwear impressions to ensure matching samples are highly detailed and have individual characteristics of the actual soles, because this will really help increase the odds of a positive identification or a high correlation of a match to be found. Now, footwear evidence collection, detection, and recovery of footwear evidence from a scene of a crime is important, because different shoes will leave behind prints of various sizes and also patterns. So this is looking here, kind of the area kind of circled and highlighted to allow for further investigation of those particular areas. So again, looking at could be dirt, could be soil, could be blood, could be all sorts of other potential fluids that could be transferred, such as paint. But it's always important to take a quality picture with a ruler in that image, and so any other information you can provide to help you further identify that print or use it as part of telling the story of the crime scene. Now, you want to have control over the crime scene. This is very important for many reasons, really to prevent destruction of evidence and limit the amount of unrelated prints made, as amongst other kind of pieces of evidence. So this is why it's very important to establish control of that crime scene very early on, because it will just help solidify the information that you find with having you to reduce the time spent culling out or eliminating certain evidence that's found that is not part of the actual crime scene, but was found or placed in after the fact. So locating and recovering footwear, those particularly impressions that I mentioned, it's critical that proper techniques be used to locate, document, and recover the footwear's evidence. Full and partial prints must be recovered. Again, just because you didn't find a full print, it's not necessarily a bad piece of evidence. Even partial prints can be utilized. And this only can happen if the scene is secured and you're allowed to go in and collect the evidence. The documentation of those prints, well, for footprints located, location should be documented and photographed, enhancing evidence as necessary where it may be needed. Some prints can be visualized by darkening the room and using a bright light at a low angle to try to get that kind of shadow line. Really important here, as we kind of see in the snow and the mud, we have a deeper print, kind of reducing the angle that light may come in can really help bring out some of the shadows and really help intensify that print on a photographic image. And as you're going through and photographing, quality photograph is important and should be taken of the impressions if they cannot be transported. So a lot of times it might be in place, but taking good quality photographs are important. Those photos can be taken for later comparison with suspect footwear, therefore they must be very clear. Scale should be used to gauge the size of the footprint, because that can help act as potential class evidence as well. Here's how to kind of properly take a photograph technique of a footwear print. I could see kind of an alternate light source kind of going straight vertically down on the in the potential print, everything marked, the camera on a tripod to allow a very steady photograph, the photographer wearing very protective equipment, also covering the soles of their shoes to eliminate any confounding footprints to be made that would only have to later be eliminated. And lastly, recovering the footprints. Objects with footprints should be removed if possible, so if they're on paper or glass. Since this often is not an option, examination in those photographs with a rule for size comparison do become very important. Producing known impressions of shoes being examined and comparing crime scene impressions with the footwear. And this could be, as I said, on a hard surface here, or it could be on a very soft surface. Being able to kind of recover those footprints and act as comparison can be a very critical piece of evidence.